Good morning, students. I'm extremely happy that you're all promoted to class 6. Welcome to 6th standard ICSE. I'm your science teacher. Based on whatever you have learnt in your previous science classes, we can say that science is truth. Whatever we see around us is science, isn't it, children? The plants, the animals, the air, water, climate, the heavenly bodies. Children, some think that science is only how a body works, but it is not so. It is all about the things around us. Science is whatever we are handling. Science is actually a very vast, very broad subject. So they have divided science into two broad categories, okay, two group we can say. So since science is a very big subject, they have divided science into two categories. The first one is study of living being. The study of living being is called life science. So this is the first group. And the second one is study of non-living things. So the study of non-living things is called material sciences. So we have seen two groups in science. First one is life science and second one is material science. And again in the first group, life science, it is further divided into two more subjects. The first one is zoology. Okay, zoology is the study of animal life. Okay, all the animals and human being, the study of animal life is called zoology. And the next one is botany. Botany is the study of plant life. So children, botany and zoology together, it is called as biology. Okay, now we'll come to the material science. The material science is also divided into three main subjects. And the first important subject there is physics. And the second important subject is chemistry. And the last one is your geology. So these are the subjects that come under science. And this year we'll be introducing three important subjects in science. And first one is biology. Second one is your physics. And third one is your chemistry. So we all know biology is the study of life. Okay, then what about physics? Physics is almost everything that you see around us. The electricity, the machines we use in our home, the modes of transport, the communication, the gadgets and other appliances we use, everything work under the principle of physics. So physics is very important. Next is chemistry. Is chemistry also important? Yes, of course, because chemistry is involved in all the life processes that happen in our body. Okay, so chemistry is also important. It is not only in our body, but also chemical reactions are happening in plants and as well as around us. Apart from this, chemistry can help us in many ways. The pesticides we use is made of lot of chemicals. The medicines we use is made of chemicals. The textiles we use are made up of chemical dyes. So everything is based on chemistry. You'll be learning in detail. And the last one is geology, the study of earth and heavenly bodies. So these are the subjects in science. So this year you'll be studying three subjects. You'll be having three separate books, okay? One book for chemistry, which has got seven lessons, which has got six lessons, and another book for physics, which has got seven lessons, and one book for biology, which has got eight lessons. And today, you're going to see the first chapter in biology, the science of life. Okay, so in this chapter, you'll be just recalling the characteristic of living being. So you can watch the video link I have sent. You can watch the video and find out the characteristic of living being. And I request everyone to take down the key points in your common notebook and complete your assignment, and then and there you must revise your portions also. Thank you, children. Thank you for listening patiently.